Hi, I'm Pawel and I make games. I'm gonna show you which of the objects from the scene 1 will be interactive and quickly create scene 2 out of sprites. Moreover, we will talk about and fix a minor bug in this game. We will start with the fireplace. We need a new component, it's item data, and we need to choose item ID and required item ID. In that case, we only need to get the order in which items will be used, so let's think about that for a moment. The plant needs some water, so since it's the first item we use, let's give it 0. Plant has a required item 0 and water is item ID 0. Then we use the plant on the big man and we get some booze. Its item ID is 2 and it requires 1. Then we use the booze on the fireplace to give it to the Senna. So the fireplace is number 3 and requires number 2. Alright, now we need a go-to point for our fireplace. Let's create a new game object and name it go-to point. Let's see where it is and let's move it over there and use it in the item data. Alright, let's give this fireplace a name and I think we need a bigger name tag. Now about the hint, let's write something about the booze. Let it be, I need some booze for Santa. Let's write it in two lines. So first we will need to change this value to 1.3 and break this line somewhere over here. Alright, now let's copy this plant UI image to save us some time and let's check what we need to change here. First we need to move it to the fireplace and using the rect tool we need to resize it. Now let's change its name to fireplace UI image, let's get rid of this number and go to the event trigger. We will need to replace plant with the fireplace item data. And that's it, I think. Let's check that out. Okay, we click this fireplace and as you can see this hint box is a bit too low, so we need to move it a little bit up and our layers behave a little bit weird. Let's go to the hint canvas and let's check how much higher it needs to be. 0.2 would be great. Let's exit the play mode and rewrite this volume so Unity will save those changes. Okay, now let's do something with those layers. First we need to use this option to add a new layer. We will create one. Let's name it UI layer. And now we need to use it in the hint canvas, in the name tag canvas, and in this canvas with plant and fireplace UI images. Now the name tag won't hide behind the player, but it is not over. We still need to set the correct order in layer for every canvas. We should give our canvas with everything we click on the highest order in layer, because that way it will be rendered at the top of everything and can't be covered by anything else, like hint box. Now I think our name tag should be higher than the hint canvas, which is on 0. And that means we need our first canvas to be number 2. Alright, let's enter the play mode and check that out. We click on this fireplace and our layers work properly now. But yeah, this hint box is a bit too low. And why is that? We have 0 here, but as we exit the play mode, we have 0.2. That's because we change it in our script. We won't touch the script today, so let's just get rid of this value here and add it to hintbox, not its parent. Great, it finally looks fine. Alright, now let's take care of those paintings. There is a little question mark, so I think it would be a good idea to use this painting as something to give a hint. Let's clone this fireplace UI image and let's rename it to hint painting UI image. We don't need this number and let's go to the scene view. Let's move it somewhere over here and make it smaller. And now it's fine. Now we need to go to the scene and create a new empty game object to store this painting's item data because it's a part of the background, so we can't do this as we did before. We can put this wherever, let's say on the top, and we need an item data here. Let's do a trick over there and use a negative value in the required item ID. But you can't use -1 because we use it in tryGettingItem function, and it means that if we see -1, we don't need any items to pick this item up. So if we pick this item up, we won't see the hint message. And the whole point of this object is to show the hint message. So we're gonna use -2 because it's the closest unused negative integer. Alright, the hint will be the room on the right. It's quite general. And let's give this object a name hint. I don't think we need that big name tag, but what we need is a go to point. We'll give it a name go to point and move it somewhere over there. And don't forget to use it in this item data. And now we need to use this item data in hint painting UI image in those two places. Alright, it works good, but we need a bigger hint box. Now it's good. Let's keep moving. Let's clone this object we've just created and let's rename it to main objective. And it's also a painting. Let's use this name in the object name and we don't need to tell the player it's a painting. And as it comes to a hint, we will write something like escape with Santa. I think that's enough. We don't need that big hint box and the name tag is too small. Alright, and we need a UI image for this bad boy. Let's rename it to main objective painting UI image. And get rid of this number. And now we may use main objective painting as a item data here and move this UI image to the right. It's a bit too wide, so let's change its width to 4. And now it looks fine, doesn't it? Oh, and don't forget to move its go to point too. So let's grab it and move it somewhere over here. Now as we go to the play mode, we can see that this name is too big for this name tag. So let's make it a bit wider. And now it looks fine, but I think we may make it shorter and it will look better. So let's change it to 2 and let's rename this object to goal. And let's also rename its game object. And it would be silly if we leave this UI image as it is, so let's rename it 2. Alright, this name looks better, I think. And as we click on this painting, we have two problems. First of them is the moonwalk and the second of them is too big hintbox. To easily fix it, let's move go to point a bit to the left. We also need to make this hintbox a little bit bigger. Ok, Okay, for now it looks fine and we will get rid of the moonwalk later on. Now we better deal with creating a new scene. First we need to copy and paste this first scene and rename it to scene 2. And now get rid of some of the trash from the scene 1. Let's open scene 2 and select everything except our canvas. We will need it. And except our background. The rest may go away. Alright, now we may disable the scene 1 and let's open our sprite sheet. We will swap our background image. And now we need to add new elements to our room and rename them. Alright, if you want to, you may watch me doing it, and if not, you may skip a few seconds from this video. A sprite number 41 is our soldier. Now we need a table, we need to find it. Okay, there it is. It's number 30. Let's rename it to a table. We need a water bottle on it. Let's rename it. And what we need? We need to move those objects. The big man would be right there, the soldier here, and the table there. Alright, we need to duplicate the soldier. Let's name him Soldier 2. And let's move him to the right. Alright, now we have two soldiers near the table. What do we need? Maybe let's add a dropped bottle here. It's number 27. Let's move it near the big man and let's rename it. Okay, we have every sprite we need and it's time to fix some things. First of them is that we need to move the player character outside of the scene 1 because she will be traveling across the whole game. Now let's go to the scene 2 and look at it. A dropped bottle is a part of the background, so let's move it there. And let's change its ordering layer to make sure that it won't be visible, for example, in front of the player. We have this soldier 2, so let's make him look at the soldier 1. Now it looks better. And we have a water bottle. Water bottle should be on a table, not behind it, so let's change the table's ordering layer to -1. And let's move the bottle a little bit. Alright, as we enter the play mode, we will snap those sprites to grid and get some errors, but actually I think they are from this canvas, because we still use some old stuff. So let's get rid of three of those UI images and leave one to rename it and use it as a big man UI image. Now we need to move it somewhere over there to cover up the big man. Make it a little bit wider so it would be easier to click on. And I think we need only one more for the table with the water. Duplicate this big man UI image, let's rename it to water on a table and move it somewhere over there. Let's resize it to cover up those two soldiers and water. And as we treat it as a one object to click, let's create empty game object. Let's rename it to, let's say, water on a table. Reset its position. And oh, and make sure that it's a child object of scene 2. And we need to reset its position again because of that. And we may hide those soldiers and table here. And after all of that, we have only two objects and two UI images. So this scene is a little bit better organized than it was before. What the next step will be? It it's time to hide everything and disable scene 2, go back to the scene 1, and that way we'll leave a nice and tidy project for the next episode. In this episode we added a lot of content to our game without even writing a single line of code. This will change in the next one. We are going to write a scene transition script. Have a good day and see you soon!